Here we have a model of the leg, and we're in the back of the leg, the posterior leg. So here's the back of the thigh, the hamstring muscles. Here's the calf, and then you can see the foot here. This is going to be medial, and this is going to be lateral. So you can see the big toe and the pinky here, just to orient ourselves. And we're just going to take a 360 view from the back to the front and then back around. So the major muscle of the posterior leg, the posterior lower leg, the calf, is actually two muscles. And here you can see the major muscle that forms kind of the curve of the calf. And this is called the gastrocnemius, the gastrocnemius. It actually has two parts. You can see I could remove one. But the major, the other major muscle of the calf, the gastrocnemius, is called the soleus muscle. And you can see a little bit of the soleus muscle here. And you can also see it extending over here. And the gastrocnemius and the soleus muscle both attach to this connective tissue that wraps around the heel of the foot and attaches to the underside of the foot. And this is called the calcaneal tendon, or the Achilles tendon, so named for a mythological character. So the calcaneal tendon here, or the Achilles tendon, you can use either. And you can see that it goes around the calcaneus bone, the heel bone. So again, the back of the thigh here, we have our the back of the calf, we have the gastrocnemius muscle and then the soleus muscle here. So I'm going to rotate it around. Now I'm looking at the lateral view of the leg. And again, here you can see the gastrocnemius and you can see the soleus muscle and the calcaneal tendon. And you can see here's the pinky of his of the foot. And then here we have the peroneus muscle. And you can see that this peroneus muscle attaches to that lateral malleolus running down the lateral part of the lower leg. So the peroneus muscle. And then coming along towards the front. So now we're looking in the anterior view. So here's the top of the foot and his knee. And again, you can see a little bit of the gastrocnemius and the soleus and that peroneus muscle. And then here we're going to have two major muscles. The first one is called the extensor digitorum longus. The extensor digitorum longus, so named because it runs down the front of the shin and attaches to the tendons of the top of our foot. And when contracts, you can see that's going to bring my toes, right? It's going to extend my toes, spread my toes out instead of curling my toes. So the extensor digitorum longus. And then the major muscle that runs right down the front of the thigh, right along the tibia, and you can see the tibia here, right along the tibial crest, is called the tibialis anterior muscle. The tibialis anterior muscle. And you can see that here. And then it's just more medially located from the extensor digitorum longus. So the extensor digitorum longus, the tibialis anterior. Coming to the medial view, you can still see the tibialis anterior and the tibia here. And then you have this muscle here, and this is called the flexor digitorum longus. The flexor digitorum longus. And you can see how it runs down the back of the tibia and actually extends, right, and attaches to the underside of the foot. And it's going to be, it's called the flexor digitorum longus because when it contracts, because it attaches to the tendons on the underside of the foot, it's going to actually help curl the toes or flex the toes. So here you have the flexor digitorum longus. And it's deep to, if I were to remove the gastrocnemius and the soleus muscle, here's the calcaneal tendon. If I were to remove that, you would get a good view of that flexor digitorum longus. And then just to complete our 360 degree view, again, here's that flexor digitorum longus, and then the soleus muscle, and then the gastrocnemius.